This is Next Radio.
With Broadcast Bionics. Innovative solutions for creative people.
Like I'm human, please. Hi. Can you just stand up and say your names to us? Because we want the time. We've only got 18 minutes, and quite frankly, I want to get to know everything about everybody because I'm so nosy. So if you could just stand up for us and just shout your name, that would be amazing. Thank you.
So nice to meet you.
I'm Sharon.
And I'm Lenja. And we are the behind-the-scenes girls who do work with the people off air so that the people on air and off air could do a great job. So this song was You and Me.
That means me plus you equals us. It's why we're here with you today. We're going to challenge you. We want to inspire you. And we want to send you out into the radio world as brave ambassadors for this fantastic medium. Our company was set up to do exactly that. We've both been working in radio for far too many years. I used to present with a boombox and, I think, acetate notes. So you can kind of date me from there. What I want to talk to you about today, or what we want to talk to you about, is inspiration. We're going to get you to take that leap out of your comfort zone. But I'll talk about that a little bit later.
Yeah, you know, and we're all here because we love radio, right? This is what connects us. But then what happens is that I go to Google and I Google, is radio dying? And I get 105 million results, okay, in 0.29 seconds. I don't want this to happen, okay? We don't want this to happen because radio is a great medium, right? And I think it's great because all of you are doing a great job. So give yourself a round of applause right now. And you've all heard, raise your hands if you've heard about Death Valley. Yeah? Death Valley was received a great, great surprise in 2004. What happened is that there was 7 inches of rain in Death Valley in 2004. And the next spring, there was a bed of flowers. So Death Valley is not dead, okay? So the seeds were beneath the surface and it just needed the right conditions. And it's the same with radio. Nobody can say that radio is dead. It just needs the right conditions, and you all do this every day to make it happen. So you see, these are the flowers in Death Valley. And radio is alive, thank you very much, and all of us are doing this. And today we want to present the 9 values of a radio warrior or a true radio ambassador. So the thing is that, you know, a radio warrior is somebody who is brave and is somebody who fights for what he believes in. And we all believe in radio, otherwise we wouldn't be here. So we're going to present these 9 tactics, and they're going to be about how to create and maintain great relationships and how to win the heart and the minds. I said heart and the minds of your clients, your team, and your listeners. And Ms. Sharon, the stage is yours.
Thank you very much. Okay, the first thing to talk to you about is get out of your rocking chair. Quite a few of you will remember Terence Trent D'Arby's song, Get Out of Your Rocking... Anybody remember that? God, please join me. I'm over 40. Who cares? Get out of your rocking chair. Everybody else must have heard of the comfort zone. You know, wearing the slippers to work, everything is like same old, same old. Anyone ever driven to work and thought, I really can't remember the journey this morning? Because it becomes a hobby, it becomes a habit, and we do it naturally. This is going to challenge that norm. What I want you to do is start thinking differently. I want you to think, right, this is the time that radio is going to shine. We've all got to take steps to challenge the status quo, to embrace change. In actual fact, let's not embrace change, let's create it. Let's be the engineers of it. Because that's what we need to do. We can't stand still, we've got to move forward. Now, I'm really conscious of time, so I'm going to give you a few examples, but I'll keep them really succinct. But you can do research on the internet to find out more details. In 1929, the Great Depression in America struck. And there was a CEO of a company called Post Grape Nuts. Anybody ever heard of that company? No? Okay, one person. It's not great, is it? It's not bloody brilliant awareness. And the CEO of that company at the time kind of said, you know what, we are the number one cereal brand in North America. So what I'm going to do, you know, it's a little bit windy out there, a little bit stormy, so I'm going to go over here and I'm going to hide underneath my, actually I'm going to hide in my office for about a year and hope it all goes away. Because we're number one, right? People don't change. People's habits don't change. What a load of rubbish. Let me tell you something. At that time, a brand came out and said to the people of North America, we get that you're feeling fed up, we get that you're pissed off, and we want to make your mornings better. Can anyone name that company? Kellogg's. Kellogg's came out. They understood the temperature. They understood how people were feeling, and they engaged them with their hearts and said, you know what? We're going to help you. We're going to try to make you feel better. And that's what I want to do. I want to give you some tools and some advice as to how to get your people to just step out of the rocking chair, make the leap out of the comfort zone, because that's where the magic happens. I hate technology, by the way. I'm glad it's free to fail, though. Freedom to fail is one of the things I used to talk to our teams about when I was working at The Guardian for GMG. And it is the oil of innovation. If you want to do things differently, make a difference, and come up with new ideas, give your people and yourselves freedom to experiment. We're all carrying around this baggage. You see every day in the newspaper, jobs lost, economy crap, all this kind of stuff. I want you to think about what you can do to make a difference. It's so important that you have and give your team members freedom to fail. It's the oil of innovation in our country, in UK and worldwide. Recently, when I was asked to do this talk, there was a case study that I came across. The ex-CEO of Starbucks, a guy called Jim McDonald, now works for a company called Travel Stay, and he walked into that business and everyone was paralyzed by fear. They weren't taking risks. They were literally like, yes men, oh yeah, here's the new CEO, we'll do whatever you want. Do you know what he did? He gave every single one of his 9,000 employees a get out of jail free card. It said, you have freedom to fail, I have your back. How would you feel if you walked into the office tomorrow and your boss gave you one of those? I mean, I'm not saying spend millions of pounds on a new software design and then go back to the CEO and go, sorry, I've bankrupted the company. But these risks and these small changes can make massive difference. Be brave. Let me tell you something. I think I have used the ladies' bathroom more times in one morning than I've used it in the last month. Bravery is not the absence of fear, but the mastery of it. You've kind of got to turn yourself on to thinking, do you know what? It's human to be brave, but you've got to do these things to make a difference. It's about standing by your principles. It's about doing the right thing by clients. You know, if you're walking in, as I say, we work on the commercial side of things, and I will give you an example. I worked with a wonderful girl in up north. I won't out her out here. And she was having a very difficult time. She hadn't hit a target for, I don't know, 3 months. And she was on this spiral of disbelief. She'd lost her confidence. You know that kind of thing where you're almost a self-fulfilling prophecy. So you're walking in going, this is brilliant. And you haven't got any faith and belief in yourself. And with that lack of confidence, personal confidence, came a lack of confidence in the product that she was selling and the results it could deliver to her clients. So we had to create bravery in her to do the right thing by her clients, to have a focus, have a strategy, and to pick her head up. Because what she was doing was she was just accepting what people were giving her. She was just saying, okay, we'll take that order, we'll take that order, instead of adding value to the client and saying, do you know what? I don't care whether you've got free parking. It's not going to make a difference to my clients' lives. She's now one of the top salespeople in the company. On Christmas Eve last year, so 2012, I got one of the best text messages of my life. And it said, I am taking my son and my boyfriend on holiday. I am now the best performing person in the group, or I'm heading that way. She's actually the best performing in that area. And she signed up a client for £200,000. She hadn't been brave enough to go out there and say, do you know what? This is how powerful our medium is. And she's done it.
Okay.
Sharon. Okay. Right. Don't be a yes person. We just want you to challenge the status quo. We have to make sure that we are not just taking orders, that we are innovative, and that we are giving people our freedom to fail. Henry Ford said, if I'd have given my clients what they wanted, we'd all have fast horses. Think about it.
Number five, asking is listening. It doesn't make much sense when you say it at first, but here are two examples. When I left for London, I said, I'm going to speak at a conference in London. And the answer of my co-worker was, really, I've never been to London before. And the second answer could be, oh, wow, what's the subject? What's the conference called? Do you see the two differences in the sub-question that somebody asks? And it's the same when you go to talk to your clients, right? Sometimes you just go your own path instead of asking sub-questions, which means that you are listening to them and you care about them. So I want you to go and talk to potential clients or to your team, and you have to ask him this question. Ask him, what are your three biggest challenges? Don't talk about your ratings, because believe me, every time a salesperson starts talking about ratings, one goldfish dies. Okay, so I want you to ask sub-questions. Don't just have yourself in the mind, but they are important. So then we have number six. Brand is dead and the love mark is born. What is a brand? Brand is a company that makes money. I believe love mark is a company that makes money and changes the world. Okay, so let's say that a brand or a love mark is a brand with a heart surgery. Okay, this bit. So we're adding the love, the emotion bit that you have with your clients and with your staff. So a love mark is a brand that has an inspirational story that is authentic, that is remarkable, and people want to follow you because you too have the same values. Okay, then we have, this is the most important question, and this is one of the most important values that we have. Are you successful? I know you are, but do you matter to your clients? And do you matter to your team? And do you matter to your listeners? This is one of the most important questions that you can ask yourself. Be a business diamond. What does that mean? A business diamond is somebody who knows what makes him different from anybody else. And I want you to do this with your team tomorrow. Get a match. I just hope the water will sprinkle everywhere. So I'm sorry, Matt, I didn't tell you about this because I knew you'd say no. So anyway, this is a match. Do this with your team. They have, by the time I light the match and it burns out, they need to tell you why somebody would choose you instead of another radio station. Why somebody would employ you instead of somebody else. And don't give me the cliche blah, blah, blah bollocks, okay? The best, the cheapest, the most inspiring, that shit, people don't believe that anymore. So I want you to turn to your neighbor, okay? And until it burns out, I want you to tell me why your station, your company is different than anybody else. Okay? I'll burn it. When it burns out, I'll light it. And it burns out, talk, and then you stop talking. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
I need to be quick now.
Yeah.
I'm burning! Stop! It's difficult, isn't it? But this is the 35 seconds companies have to touch the brain and to touch the hearts of potential clients. Okay, moving on. Oh my God, Matt, we're running late. what's the next one? Be human, show that you care, damn it. Be human. It's so ironic that today I need to teach companies to be human again, okay? To use the name when you write an email. That when you think about what should we do next, that you think this is not the customer or client, but just use the word friend. And then you'll see that your perspective will change and you will do things differently, okay? And I'll just want to tell you that when you are working with your clients, it's not important what you give them, but how you make them feel around you or how your product or service can change their lives. Just a quick story about a woman who went out with two politicians for a dinner. And after the dinner, they asked her, "So how did you find it?" And she said, "Well, this one guy is unbelievable. He's the smartest person in the world." And then they said, "What about the next guy?" "Well, this one is amazing, but he made me feel like the smartest person on the planet." That is the difference that you have to do with your clients. They have to feel good because of you. And this is a commercial I did, a big, big pro bono campaign I did for a maternity hospital in Slovenia. I had zero budget, and I persuaded 65 of 82 radio stations in Slovenia to give me free advertising. And I needed to get 50,000 euros in 10 days, only through radio advertising, because I wanted to prove the radio people in Slovenia that we can do it just with radio. I didn't want newspaper, TV. They wanted me to have it, but I said, no, I believe in radio. And it was an ad which had a call to action at the end. So we could basically measure the results, right? Because there you have to send a text message and donate 1 euro. In 10 days, I got 40,000 euros just through text messages. And that was 7 years ago in Slovenia, which is like a 2 million market. You can do this. If a blonde Slovenian girl can, then you can too.
She's not really blonde, though.
Shut up, I am.
Noseča je 12 tednov. Vsaka njena misel je namenjena malemu popku. Jaz pa še ne čutim ničesar. In počutim se tako prazno. Včeraj sva šla na ultrazvok. Tukaj je leva rokica, tukaj nosek, so govorili. Jaz pa na monitorju nisem prepoznal kaj dosti. Pa tako rad bi ga začutil bliže. Povedali pa so mi, da najsodobnejši ultrazvok svojo izjemno kakovostno sliko in 3D prikazom otročička omogoči to bližino. Bližino z malim popkom. V dobrodelni akciji Otroci so popki sveta bomo tak ultrazvok podarili bolnišnici Postojna. Pošlite SMS z besedico popek na 1919 in podarite $230. Hvala.
The biggest reward was a dad calling me from highway saying, thank you, I don't feel like a freak anymore. This is how I feel. So I wrote these radio ads in half an hour, and I was crying like a little baby when I did them, because they are human and they care about the audience. So we'll skip this. So again, just go through this so that you remember the 9 tactics or the 9 values of a radio warrior who fights for what he believes. And you believe in radio, so let's fight some more. And we want to let you go with this. If there would be no you, no radio company, no radio stations which you belong to, what would the world be missing? And all of these people were on the stage today, and they had the privilege to do this. But just because we're on a stage doesn't mean we know anything better or we love radio more than you. So you have something to share with the radio world. Please do this, okay? And I just want to say that it's unbelievable to be here with all these people and feeling the radio love. So thanks again, and goodbye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Really useful, practical tips that you can immediately kind of take back and talk to your teams about and start to work through. And that's really great, to be able to leave with something that you can immediately put into practice. It's really, really helpful.
It's just insightful, really insightful and inspiring.
And it just twigs off things in your brain or kind of conversations with other people in the industry that you maybe wouldn't have had sat at your desk with your colleagues.
This is Next Radio.
With Broadcast Bionics, innovative solutions for creative people.